B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to build an Arduino motion detection alarm by modifying a smoke alarm. There's a lot you can do with a smoke alarm, a modified smoke alarm. Today we're going to do motion detection. So we're going to turn it into a motion detector. And what you'll need for this is, I'm using an Elegoo Uno. You can use a Mega, you can use a Nano, but I'm using an Uno. You also need a PIR, a motion sensor, and you'll need three female-to-male jumpers, and then a couple of male-to-male jumpers. Now, coming out of the smoke alarm here is my positive wire and my negative wire plugged into the ground rail here. These are 24 gauge, and I soldered those onto the circuit board, and I'll show you how I did that in just a minute. But this is just the cheapest smoke alarm that I could find on Amazon, and it is ear piercing, so I do have a towel to put over it when it goes off. It is loud, it's a fun project, so let's see how it's done. So the wiring is really quick and simple. We'll go over that real fast. Your red wire here coming out of your motion detector is the closest to the yellow jumper. That's how I remember that it's negative, so it's going into the negative rail over here. The middle wire is the sensor wire, and I have it going into pin 8, digital pin 8. Now, I could use pin 9, pin 7, but I just chose pin 8. And then the white wire over here, the one furthest from the side with the yellow jumper, is my positive wire, and I have that going into my 5-volt pin on the Uno board. Another thing to keep in mind is that you have two adjustments here at the top of your motion sensor. Remember that the one closest to the yellow jumper here on the side, that's your sensitivity. How close, how far do you want it to sense motion? The next one over, the one furthest from your yellow jumper pack here on the side, that is your hold delay. How long do you want to wait before it kicks in to detect motion again? So you can play around with those, see what works best for you. Now down here, my white wire coming out of the smoke alarm is my positive. So my positive will go in pin 13. Again, you could do pin 12, whatever. My digital pin 13, that's where that'll be. My red wire is negative, and I'll put that in my negative rail right here. And then finally, to connect the circuit, I will connect the negative rail to the ground pin here on my board. And that's all you need to do. The smoke alarm that I'm using is the KIDDE, KIDDE or KIDDE or whatever, I-9030, model I-9030. I want to show you what I did when I took the back off. There is a tab right under the sticker right here, and when you break that, you void any warranty. You can't use it as a smoke alarm any longer, so keep that in mind. So there are a total of three tabs you have to squeeze to remove the back. There's tab number one, tab number two, and tab number three. Once you remove the back, you'll see that the circuit board is fixed in there, and you'll just want to remove the tab and pull that circuit board out so you can have access to the back, because that is where we will solder our new wires. Now, I've spared you the soldering video, so I'll just show you what I did. The red wire is my positive, and the white wire is my negative. The white wire over here is soldered where the battery pack goes. You can see that from the front there. And then my other wire is right here, and it's actually connected to the button, the test button. So whenever the test button's pressed, it makes a connection there, and at the connection is where I soldered the red wire. Now, there are several places that you could solder your wire, but this worked for me and I tested it. See, when you press that plate down and it makes a connection to that metal piece, that'll sound the alarm. So it only made sense to make my connection right there, right underneath it. So pretty easy, pretty simple, anybody could do it. Here's another look, if I just fit everything together, of how the button works, the test button. The plastic cover comes over top of that LED, and then the corner of that plastic piece pushes on the little metal bridge there. And when that pushes down, it connects to the, it looks like a staple. And then that connects the circuit, and the buzzer goes off. And that is where we soldered our positive wire. And the next step is to screw in your buzzer, and then go ahead and slip your circuit board back under the tabs to secure it in place, just like you found it. Now moving on to the code for this project. It's pretty short, very simple. Up here we choose a pin for the smoke alarm, pin 13, and choose a pin for the sensor, which is pin 8. And then the PIR state is low, and that's assuming that no motion is detected. And then here's the variable for reading the pin status, 0. And you come down here to the setup, set your smoke alarm as an output, and set your input pin, which is your motion detector pin, as an input. So declare sensor as input. And then of course we include our 9600 baud for our serial monitor, because we want to open a serial monitor so that we can see if there's any issues. So come down here to the loop, and all we need to do is read the digital pin. If that value is high, the smoke alarm comes on, and it says motion detected on our serial screen, our serial monitor, which will open up here in just a minute, and otherwise the smoke alarm will stay off. And that's it. The next thing we're going to do is flip our smoke alarm over because it's loud, and then cover it with a towel because that really gets annoying. So it's covered. I'm going to go ahead and plug in my positive pin to 13. You can't see all of my serial monitor, but basically it just says motion detected, motion ended. Every time I wave my hand in front of the motion sensor here, like now, and of course there's a delay afterwards, and you can make that delay anything you, however long you want, and I can wave my hand in front of it again. So I'm pretty close to it, and I've never had any issues working close with the motion sensor, but most data sheets that I've seen say that it works up to 7 meters. Well, here is a schematic if you need it, and that's all I have for today. Hopefully you found the video useful. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you again soon. Thanks for watching.